Perimenopause is the time between a woman's usual menstrual cycles and her final period. It's part of the menopause transition. Perimenopause often begins in the 40s and can last 4 to 8 years or more. You can still get pregnant during perimenopause. It's important to know what changes to expect, especially when it comes to menstrual bleeding. During your reproductive years, the hormones estrogen and progesterone work together to regulate menstrual bleeding. For most women, the levels of these hormones rise and fall in a regular pattern throughout the menstrual cycle. As you move through perimenopause, the predictable rise and fall of hormones changes. The first changes in your period might be subtle. Your period might be lighter 1 month or heavier another. Or you may have spotting instead of a period. Later in perimenopause, you may skip a period 1 month and have a normal or unusually heavy or long period the next month. Any change from your normal bleeding is called abnormal uterine bleeding, even when these changes are an expected sign of perimenopause. Track the changes you notice and bring these details to your next OBGYN visit. Some changes are concerning, such as significant changes in how long your period lasts or the time between your periods. It is also concerning when bleeding lasts more than 7 days or there is bleeding between periods. Other concerning bleeding is spotting or bleeding after sexual intercourse, flooding or gushing when you stand up or get up in the morning, passing blood clots the size of a quarter or larger, bleeding that requires you to change tampons or pads or empty your menstrual cup every hour, or bleeding that is so heavy you have to double up on pads. If you experience any of these signs and symptoms, call your OBGYN. Sudden severe episodes of abnormal bleeding can also happen in perimenopause. This is called acute abnormal uterine bleeding. If you are experiencing heavy bleeding and you also have chest pain, have shortness of breath, and are lightheaded or dizzy, seek emergency medical care right away. When you see your OBGYN about bleeding changes, they should look at your personal and family health history and conduct a physical exam and order tests as necessary. Together, you can discuss test results and if treatment is needed. Depending on the cause, medications are often tried first to treat irregular or heavy menstrual bleeding. Treatments are aimed at reducing heavy bleeding and improving your quality of life. If medication does not reduce your bleeding, you and your OBGYN may talk about more testing and perhaps a surgical procedure. Talking with your OBGYN can help you understand what you're experiencing and whether your changes are typical of perimenopause. The earlier the cause of the abnormal bleeding can be diagnosed, the better it can be managed. And remember, menopause is confirmed after 12 months in a row of no periods. You should not have any vaginal bleeding or spotting if you have gone 12 months in a row without a period. Make an appointment with your OBGYN right away if you have postmenopausal bleeding or spotting. The bleeding changes that happen during perimenopause can be unsettling, but working with your OBGYN can help. Together, you can talk about abnormal bleeding and possible treatments that can improve your quality of life.